I just want to real quickly go through a few portfolio images that I've got. And these are some various images from paying projects that I've had in most in these various NC locations. I mentioned I used Lightroom to put these together, and that was the quickest part of the whole process. So I love software. I'm putting these, I put this gallery up online, and I'll make this link available to everybody if you want to spend more time looking through it and asking questions. And this is really just a smattering of indoor and outdoor images. These are some custom homes that have been shot in the mountains with developers that that I've worked with over the past few years. Multifamily project in Asheville through a modular home developer, and this particular property with the help of these photographs actually won a Best in Place award. You can do larger spaces. This was the Arboretum, I think, in Asheville. And this is where the real wide-angle lenses come into play, because you can just get an enormous coverage with these things. Exterior residential properties. This is, I think, around Kramer Mountain. Interiors as well as exteriors. You know, they're the kinds of things you expect to see from any architectural photographer. And there are just some really, really beautiful homes out there. And you know, even if you know people who just have nice homes, you just kind of work with them to get in there and shoot them for your portfolio. That's what I did to get started. Offer them complimentary portfolios of or CDs of their pictures, and then use those images to solicit work. These are some custom properties around Lake Norman, some interior work that we did for a developer. And the detail as well as the wide-angle stuff is always a good mixture of stuff. This is my favorite master bath. I think the properties are more impressive than anything else. And they actually have homes with wine cellars in this state, believe it or not. Kids' rooms. And you know, these are the kind of houses that that you can get. And these are, you know, equipment-wise, these were shot with fairly basic equipment. Anything from a 10 megapixel up camera will give you the quality you need, as long as you're not trying to really post-produce, you know, 24 by 36 murals or things like that. And then, as I mentioned, you can actually even stitch things together using Photoshop's Automate function to get some of the larger scenes. I'm trying to forward through to, for instance, in this area, over the last couple of days. There's some really good architectural targets to just build a portfolio in and around the Raleigh-Durham area as well. These are some restaurants and other homes that have been shot. Like I said, it's all basic stuff. It's just attention to detail, and then on the backside, which we don't have time to get into today, but using a lot of transform functions in Photoshop as well as filters to correct lens distortions. This is an example, by the way, of a stitched panorama. It's a 180-degree panorama that Photoshop stitched together 8 different photos. And you can see that with a characteristic distortion in the ceiling, but it's kind of a neat artsy shot, and the client loved this one. I had the good fortune to shoot a lot of different kinds of things, from restaurants to people's homes. Of course, this is one of my favorites from the last couple of weeks. This is right down the street. Dorton Arena is just a real telltale image of Raleigh, and then there's just so many interesting properties around that you can just pretty much go out and build your portfolio on the weekends and then do some cool stuff with it. So I think at this point, let me throw it out back to you guys.